Hey everyone, how are you? It's Mike Potenza from Becker, and I wanted to take a moment just to wish you the happiest and warmest of holidays this season. I want you to know we at Becker really value the relationship we have with everyone that utilizes our products. Whether you're utilizing Becker to study for an exam like the CPA or the CMA, or maybe you're using our CPE program for your CPE credits, or maybe you used this in the past in order to get licensed and now you're part of our alumni network and you're reaping some of the benefits we offer through our new alumni network program, we just wanted to say thank you and rest assured in 2024, just like we've done in the past, we are going to reinvest in all of our products and make sure that we have the latest, greatest products in the market. So we will continue to be the industry leader and put the highest quality product out there and utilize the latest technology to make sure that all your needs are met. So I wanted to say thank you again, and we look forward to working with you in the new year. With that said, we are an educational company. And I am a teacher. So please give me about 3 or 4 minutes to talk to you about a new law in 2024 that you might be aware of, but you might not be, but you should be aware of it, all right? So it's related to our federal government. Are they giving us a gift this season? Maybe a new itemized deduction, maybe a new tax credit. We're gonna save some money on our tax returns. The answer is no, not so much, all right? What they are doing is giving us a little extra work we're going to need to do in 2024, and you need to be aware of it, okay? So let's talk about the Corporate Transparency Act for just a few minutes. It's really important. This law has created a requirement for owners of companies to report who the owners are. And it's called the BOI, the beneficial ownership information that must now be recorded. And you say, well, why are they making me record all this information if we've never had to do this in the past? Unfortunately, there are people out there that are involved in illegal activity, and we have what we call ill-gotten gains or illegal money that they flow through certain types of entities in order to launder that money. So this new law is all about cracking down on money laundering, and it's going to affect most of us out there who either own businesses or represent people who own businesses. So let's talk about it. BOI, I'll refer to it, Beneficial Ownership Information. It is becoming active January 1st, 2024. And what this means is the following. If you own a company, you're considered a beneficial owner of a business. You control a company, you own a company, your personal information now needs to be recorded. Where does it need to be recorded? With FinCEN, the Financial Crimes Enforcement Network, which is a division of the Department of Treasury, all right? You'll have to give them your personal information as an owner. So you say, okay, Mike, well, does every company need to do this? Pretty much, with some exceptions. If you're a corporation or an LLC, that's who this is focused on. It's making them more transparent, that the government knows who owns these businesses, all right? So if you're an owner of a corporation or an LLC or even a foreign company that's registered to do business in the United States, you need to record who the owners of these companies are. So next question is, does everyone need to do this? Are there exceptions? Does Apple need to do this and Google? Answer is, of course there's exceptions. There's always exceptions, right? There are 23 main exceptions, but to summarize the most common exceptions, publicly traded companies do not need to do this. They're governed by more stringent requirements through the Securities Exchange Commission and Sarbanes-Oxley, so they're not governed by this. They do not have to register under this. Nonprofits do not have to register under this, as well as other certain large operating companies that have other stringent requirements for reporting. So we're really looking at smaller and mid-sized companies that need to report. So the next question is, well, if I need to report, how do I report? Very simple. You go to a website, www.fincen.gov/BOI, and there'll be a form there that you fill out, and it's going to be relatively simple and straightforward, but you do need to do this. Now, when do you have to do it? Well, it depends when the business was formed. Although they're starting application acceptance on January 1st, 2024, to know your deadlines, let's talk about when the companies were created. If your company was created prior to 2024, you have an entire year to report. Any time in 2024 is fine. If your company is formed in 2024, well, then you have 90 days after formation to report this information. If your company is formed in the future, 2025 or later, you will only have 30 days to report. So you see the timelines are getting smaller and smaller. And also very important, if you report, but then ownership information changes, you only have 30 days to make updates to the ownership changes, all right? So please be aware of this. If you own a company or you represent somebody that owns a company, this is very important. Finally, what if you don't do it? You say, I have enough to do. I can't worry about this stuff. Well, guess what? There's some very strict penalties involved for people that do not do this. So you should be aware of what these penalties are. First penalty, civil penalties, up to $500 per day for every day you're in violation of this. That could add up very quickly. There are criminal penalties of up to $10,000 and 2 years in jail. I don't know about you out there, but I don't want to go to jail. So I'm going to make sure that I do this for myself and for my clients. All right. So please make sure you're aware of that. And finally, you could be subject to these penalties, as I said, if you fail to file, but also if you file false information, that's fraud, right? You can't do that. Or if you fail to correct information, meaning you reported it and then it changed and you never updated it, that is going to be a big problem, okay? So with that said, again, you say, well, Mike, thanks. That's a great holiday wish you just left me with. No, I do. At Becker, we honestly wish you the warmest and happiest of holidays, but we're a teaching company. We're an educational company. So I had to take this opportunity to make sure you're aware of BOI. So with that said, thank the government for that. Don't thank me, right? Don't kill the messenger. That's all that I do. I wish you all the best in 2024, a wonderful, wonderful holiday season, and a very happy new year. See you next year.